Hello, folks. This is Scott with Dallas Paint Correction and Luxury Microfiber here in Dallas, Texas. It's about 70, 75 degrees right now. The sun is very intense, and I'm working on black paint. I've already sprayed down my car to kind of rinse it off, and I'm going to get in and start washing my car. Folks, right now, this is a dangerous moment. I got water on my car. It's black. I'm not using DI water. I'm going to up my game and use a non-pH neutral soap. This is kind of part two in revealing my secret on how to reduce or eliminate water spots for about 15 to 20 minutes when you're washing a car. I've had so many people threaten me, call me at 3 o'clock in the morning, tell me I'm unsubscribing from your channel because you're not going to tell us the secret. I never said I wasn't going to tell you. I thought maybe some of you would think it through, but that's just not the way the planet works. Very few of us actually think. So what I'm going to do is take pH. This is a Purple Power V-Comp Boat Wash. This is not a moment of how to wash your car. I just want to get this nasty goodness, right? Working in direct sunlight with a very strong soap. This soap can leave a residue behind. This is not a moment of, hey, should we wash from the top down? Should we use 9 buckets? Should we use 20 different wash mitts? I don't care. I just want to show you how to reduce water spots. So let me get some more soap in here. Now as I do this in the direct sunlight, I can notice the soap, because it's not pH neutral, is starting to streak on the paint. That is dangerous. I don't have a lot of time here, but I'm just gonna wipe this stuff in. I'll just do these three panels, right? 1, 2, 3. We'll leave the front nose kind of doing its own thing. Let me get some more soap on there. I tell you what, you can feel it in North Texas, it's going to get hot pretty soon. But right now this paint, even as I wipe it down, okay, it's hot, it's hot. As I stand here, I could actually see the evaporation. It's like smoking off the paint, the soap. But let me make sure I get a lot of soap on here. A lot of pH or non-pH neutral soap. Let's let it sit there and bake in the sun. Scott, are you crazy? Yeah, that's pretty much the way it works. I'm pretty crazy. Let me dry my hands off. Scott, are you going to leave the soap on there like that? Yep. Heck, that's nasty. That's crazy. I know. Direct sunlight, non-DI water, TDS levels kind of high in my water. Purple Power Vehicle and Boat Wash beginning to dry on the paint. Let's go in and take a look. Look at how nasty this is, right? This is how hot my paint is. Can you guys see that milky residue? It has dried that soap in certain areas and getting very, very nasty. Let's just leave it on there. Scott, you're crazy. Yeah, I know. What can we do? Maybe I'm not from this planet. Who knows? All right, let me rinse it off, right? That's what we would do. Rinse off the soap. Water spots galore, streaking galore. You'll notice a couple of things. The paint's very flat. You want to know why? There's residue on the paint from the Purple Power Vehicle and Boat Wash. That happens with non-pH neutral soaps. It also happens with a lot of pH neutral soaps as well, and that's what also makes the problem of washing a black car in direct sunlight an issue. Not only bad, nasty TDS levels in water. Now what I want to do is shake up my chemical I'm going to use and spray it on the car. I'll just spray it on these three panels. As I do this, I think you guys can kind of pick it up in the camera. The water is beginning to break up. It's actually trying to dry itself. Scott, you're using a lot of it. Don't worry about it. This is very cheap. Go ahead. This chemical is doing a couple different things in the moment. I'll explain it to you. Not only is it neutralizing the residue from Purple Power Vehicle and Boat Wash, it's actually kind of water softening. Is that a word I want to use? it's reducing or softening my water because I'm not using a DI machine or CR spotless. Now I'm gonna rinse it off and watch the water behavior change. Now the water is beading and sheeting off the car. Let's go on in and take a look. Let's take a look at the paint now. It's returned to being hydrophobic. The residue from Purple Power Vehicle and Boat Wash is gone, right? That's because what I sprayed on the car neutralized that and helped me, even though I'm working in direct sunlight. Now what I want to do is let the car dry in the sun a little bit. What I sprayed on this vehicle has put a protective barrier. It put a residue of its own on the paint, very different from the residue that Purple Power leaves behind. It's actually a protectant. Actually, folks, it's a synthetic wax. It's kind of like a sealant that allows the water spots to kind of sit in the paint, get nasty and hot again, but the deposits will not bond to the paint for up to 15 or 20 minutes. As I sit here. Now what's very interesting is I did not wash that panel, right? I just got it wet from my high TDS water. I'm gonna let that sucker dry there just as long as I do here and see what happens. Alright, this is the boring part of the video. Scott, this is black paint. This paint, even though I rinsed it off, let me put my hand on the paint. Okay, that's hot. It's not smoking hot where it burns me, but it's hot. Let's let it sit there. This chemical will give you about 15 to 20 minutes. You want to be strategic when you're washing your car, right? Do this side, do the other side. Dry it off. But this is nasty. This is a problem. Here's an area I did not treat with my car. And if I look, can you guys see the white water spots and the residue kind of starting to develop on the paint? Then if we look over here, it's not happening, right? You can see there's water on the paint, but there's not that milky residue from the water spots or the TDS waters or whatever. But if I come over here, can you guys see the white milky residue on the paint? Let me see if I get really close. You see that beyond the water spots? See that milky stuff? Yeah, that's nasty stuff. Water spots are beginning to develop on the paint. This side, it's not. Let me take my drying towel and begin to dry this paint. And I'm gonna be doing two things. Two things? And I'm gonna do one thing, but I'm also going to push the residue from that spray that I sprayed onto the car into the paint. No protection on this car, so the paint's a little grabby, but that's okay. Just gonna lightly go over it with my drying towel. Remember, I'm using non-DI water. I used a non-pH neutral soap. That should leave residue all over the paint, especially in direct sunlight like this, right? And I let it bake in the sun. Now let's go in with my camera. And let me show you how this stuff works. First, let's look at the front panel of my car again, where I did not wash it. Just let the TDS water, see those water spots? See how they develop so quickly on the paint? I let this side of the water kind of sit there just as long, but it's not there. It's not there. It gives me about 15 to 20 minutes and it stops that from developing washing in direct sunlight. See that? See that nasty stuff? If I got to chase this around the car, it's problematic, especially in direct sunlight. Some of that stuff's not going to come off. I'm going to have to use acid or polish. but I'll use acid. It's not a car that I'm going to cry about. There you go. What about the residue from the soap? The Purple Power Vehicle and Boat Wash. It's not there either. Folks, let me set you down. The residue that this cleaner left behind was a synthetic wax. So as I was drying, I was putting some protection on the paint. No, it won't last long. About 7 to 10 days. Let me put you guys down. Hate this part for you. Okay, what I use, guys, as a professional, is a chemical called PDMS. This PDMS is used in the airline industry. It's used in the car wash tunnel industry. It's what's in drying aids like the one I just used, because in this video here, I had to think about this. Some of you might have a hard time finding this. If you live in a metropolitan area, you can find this stuff at car wash tunnel industries that make chemicals for car wash tunnels. But you want to get the PDMS. It's got an emulsifier in it, so it can be diluted with water. It cost me about $1 for the jar. It's a little bit more effective than this, but this is darn close. And that's why I wanted to bring this into the videos, because all of you can find this. What I'm going to show you is the product that I just used on my paint. This is Superior Products called Formula 4 Spray Wax. It is a concentrated spray wax for automatic car washes. This is about, I paid $16 for this. I think it's about $20 retail. It's a gallon. You can dilute it 10 to 1, 4 to 1, 3 to 1. When you're working on hot paint like this, especially black, and using a non-pH neutral soap, I would tell you to bring the dilutions up to about 3 to 1. So roughly that makes you 4 gallons of this great juicy goodness for black paint and direct sunlight for about $20. That's incredibly cheap, and you put it in a 32-ounce bottle. Folks, let's go back in and look at my car. You notice this side of the car looks glossy, shiny, no water spots. Look at that nasty crap. Look at that nasty stuff on the paint. See that? That's how hot it is right now in Dallas. In fact, I want to rinse that off, or else that's just going to get worse. I'm definitely going to have to use some acid. You can see my TDS levels in the water are kind of high. And I'm working on black paint, because this paint right now, if I touch it, okay, that is hot. If I left my hand on there for 5 seconds, I'm going to burn my hand. Let's see if I, even rinsing it off, nope, those water spots are still there. I'm going to have to get in here pretty quick, so I'm going to turn this video short so I don't have a problem. But that side of the car looks great. No issues whatsoever. Folks, Formula One spray wax, bought at O'Reilly's from Superior Products, about $20 a gallon. It's a great drying aid and also a neutralizer for certain types of soaps that might be in the car when you're working in direct sunlight. It'll leave its own residue behind, but when you dry the car, that residue turns into a spray wax for you. Really, really nice product. I hope that helps you out. And you go from there. But that nasty goodness I have got to get to pretty quick, because I don't want to polish this car. I love you guys. Sorry to make you wait so long. Some of you have threatened me, called me at 3 o'clock in the morning. Scott, what was your secret recipe? Well, it's PDMS. Don't know if all of you can get that. If you live in a metropolitan area, you can find a chemical plant that will sell you the raw ingredient that can be emulsified in water or diluted in water. But if not, there's a nice alternative for you. I just figured I'd share that with you before I get threatened. People said I'm going to unsubscribe to your channel. Thank you for all your help over the years, but I don't like that you have a secret. Some of you are the biggest crybabies on the planet, and you just cannot wait. And I mean that lovingly. I wanted to see if anybody could think it through, but I'm starting to realize that doesn't work on this planet very often. Love you guys. Talk to you soon.